Old school today. All right, there we go. Hey, 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 hey. Yup, today's day 300 and 350. It's like 500 days. Joking. It's like 350. Day 350. Today I'm working on this. This is the spirit guide. The spirit guide. His name is Zero. And he's an NPC that you encounter in a really mysterious way. So you first encounter him, he's going to have like this like psychedelic effect that goes on the screen, and he appears like this, and then just he's always walking off screen, but he's basically guiding you towards his cave. If you find him, if you find his cave, what's up, Pedro? If you find his cave, you go inside his cave, and then he's not there anymore. There's some cactuses. You eat a cactus, and then he appears. So it teaches you about using the cactus and how it can reveal secrets. And also, this puts you into dungeon, into one of the special alternate dungeons. Pedro, yeah, sorry, my game show got messed up. So I can't use game show today. I have to use Open Broadcaster. So sorry, there's no chat overlay. Okay, so the next thing I want to do for this is to make it so it looks really cool when he appears on the screen. I've got him now, so he's like, you know, he just walks off the screen. But I wanted to work on the psychedelic effect where, so he like shimmers in. He looks like a mirage almost at first. I must be invincible too. That's weird. Why are those things not hitting me? Turn off invincibility. So I started the effect already. But I don't think it... Oh, I must have messed that up, actually. That is using this ID. So I need... I'm doing a lens effect for this. This is something where I run an effect over time based on a sprite. Sometimes I'll make it additive coloring. Sometimes I actually apply colors, playing with the opacity, but also applying this psychedelic shader. Avast! What's up, Salad Dogs? Avast! Are you actually on a boat right now? I got mega respect for people that are on boats. It was working a second ago. It's a boat called this island Earth. Cool. I gotta get a boat again. I used to have a boat and I lived on it and I made games on it. But I mostly made music on it. I didn't really make much games back then. Took a hiatus for making games in my life. A good like 10-year break. I didn't make games. But now I'm back in making games, and it's awesome. It's good to use so many different creative fields in one field. This is focusing on the entity here. I guess I'll try making it start. Set visible true. This effect is still not running. It's using render sprite as a parent. And it's setting this kind of 0, 0 offset, which would put it at the, like, the lower left probably of the sprite. Huh, wait a minute. Is it this bit? Oh, there he is. Oh, so it was automatically removing it? Okay, I'm gonna check out why it's just automatically destructing this psychedelic effect. Where is this call coming from? It looks like one of these is being called. What's up, Sean? Is Casey crazy? PC, Mr. Tim. Alpha's already greater than 1.0. Okay. Why is that? Life's good, man. Life's good. Doing what I love. This doesn't even have a duration. Tulur, sorry about that. I can't run my normal streaming software as Game Show, and it works great. It syncs up my audio and everything, and but now today I have to use Open Broadcaster, and it's not as good as Game Show, because it doesn't sync the audio, like, where I'm talking. Oh, you can actually kind of see my lips are almost in sync. This is crazy. Open Broadcaster is just, I've never been able to get it right. Sorry about that. It's just, it was either this or no stream. So I thought I'd just stream using this instead of no stream. Yeah, what the hell? The timer is all whack. The duration is crazy. The duration that got passed is -888. That's crazy. Oh, of course it's -888. Oh, so anyways, I'm going to fix that right now. I accidentally set a negative number for that thing's duration, and the effect didn't catch it. The effect class should, the base class for all these effects should definitely assert. Oh, wait, I already did. But for like a year. That should be a breakpoint. All right, I'll put a proper assertion here. I think I might be actually using a negative timer for some of these. And besides, if I were to do this, I would want to set the timer and the duration to the same thing. I would think. Okay, anyways, I'll leave that like this for now. I'm not really actually modifying much except for catching this in debug mode when I'm doing this because I want to see if this is right. So I'm just going to leave that code as it was basically. And fix what I was doing to generate this psychedelic effect. Instead of e.ai.timer, the duration of the psychedelic effect is going to be for like 3 seconds. It was there, but it the opening delay can see part of it. This will need to become something better. So it runs this psychedelic effect and he appears on the screen once the opening effect is done. But for now, I'm just gonna do a little timer. Yeah, phase open is 1.618 seconds. There, so now we should see that effect start. And then we gotta focus on making the effect actually cool. Right now it's not that cool. All right, it worked there. A little longer. And let's start making it actually do something neat. Right now it does this oh, it should also. There it is. Should also be lined up with the character too. So halfway, position is going to be halfway through the other entity's size, content size. So I'm going to grab this, the existing entities. So this, the way this effect works is there's two sprites. There's a sprite for the here for the NPC, and then there's a sprite for the psychedelic effect that'll go on top of it. And I need to line those up right now. So I'm basically getting the size of the real sprite. Render.sprite.get content size, and then using that as half the position. So it's like, size that. What's up, professional novice? Yo. Welcome, welcome. Sorry for the poor stream quality. I'm on OBS today because my game show subscription isn't working today, all of a sudden. Subscription-based software. Bam, man, right? They hook you into that deal, and then their shit doesn't work, and you're out of luck. You gotta go back to the free thing, Open Broadcaster, which the audio doesn't sync up for me on Mac. Oh, did it work? I think it finally. Wait a minute. It's not bright enough for sure. Actually, I couldn't even see it at all. Well, that's because it's really too. Huh. Yeah, there's a lot of progress been made, but sorry, I'm not really showing it right now. I'm working on this guy here. But yeah, I'll do a playthrough this week sometime. There's an alpha up. There's a, not an alpha. I call it alpha. The beta. The beta, there's gonna be a beta update this Thursday or Friday, late this Thursday, like early Friday morning for some people. There'll be a beta update. So before that, I'll be doing so a playthrough, like maybe later this week, like Thursday or Wednesday, I'll do a playthrough or something. But yeah, this guy I'm working on here is central to the plot of the game. So I'm working on getting him in there. So there's some more interesting things you can do besides just fight everything. Which is great. The combat's awesome. It's just nice to have a break from the combat every once in a while and do some other things, finding and still be rewarded for doing them, like finding items, discovering more of the story, exploring things and finding things rather than just, combating things all the time. How does it feel to have the project almost finished? It is nerve-wracking as hell. I'm so freaked out that I won't be able to get everything done for this game that I want to do. Yeah, so I've been pretty nervy lately, man. Very nervy. Just trying to calm my nerves, I guess, by just focusing on what excites me the most, I guess, in the game and focusing on the most important high priority things, but also doing things that are just exciting, you know? Why does this keep crashing now? Hold on, if the sprite was null, it would have returned at the top. Oh, maybe it's this too. Still not working. Either that or it's is it just like underneath or something? Oh yeah, that time I could see it. So it must be the Z order. So instead of this, I'll do like 2000 or something. Maybe it was working the whole time. It's just not bright enough or something. It's definitely not using the offset of the... That's right, it does a weaker effect for something that's under 7 seconds. So one thing to try before I keep messing with this is to make this at least 7 seconds long. Still not doing anything. I've been digging around with this for like, 15 minutes now, and it's just not working. What I want it to do is the same thing as these overall psychedelic effects. So if I did like, if this was zero. But now it's too long, so if I did, yeah, this is better. I'm just gonna do the whole effect like this. And then I'm gonna focus on an animation for him. I'll do some kind of like, I'm gonna do this with pixel art. This will be way easier. I've done this before where I tried to do some cool effect, but it just didn't look that cool. That was kind of neat seeing it just for a second. Yeah, so let's make an animation. Nice, man, you're demoing your thesis. Nervous as hell. All right, good luck, Pedro. So if I were doing some kind of warp in animation, I would start with here with this running east animation. Actually, it's probably better to do south. What's up, Massey? Run south. Okay, so this time. I guess I'll call this Mirage. At five. And his shoulders should be taller. Man. Didn't nail this perspective when I first did it. This is better. A little taller shoulders. Even more. And a little less there. Less there. Yeah, that's what that should look like. Let me fix that south walking animation while I just did that. Zero run south. Let's fix this. Perspective, man, perspective is everything. I messed up on the perspective for a lot of the art when I first made it. Interesting, Pedro. The next Dark Souls dev team. Have you guys played Dark Souls 3? Has anybody played it? Still playing two? Really? Hooked for 7 hours? Nice. Wow, that's a long gaming session. Yeah. I still gotta finish Dark Souls 1 myself. I'm a bit of a lazy gamer. I tried Titan Souls last night. Never finished DS1 Camp, really? I mean, I'd like to. I'd definitely like to. I'm just saying, I haven't had the time to finish it. Right? So many unfinished games. Really? Still Dark Souls 1, really? That's good to hear. Good to know. Yeah, I just finished Hyper Light Drifter. It was awesome. It was really great to see that kind of amazing art and story. I do have a lot of I really wish, gosh, I do have some crazy suggestions and ideas I wish they would have done to some of the game design personally. It left a bit to bit for me to desire. It was incredibly difficult too. Super duper difficult. But rewarding in the same. Yeah, loving it, totally, right? I think it's probably one of my. I would definitely say it's probably one of the best games I've ever played. Hyper Light Drifter is amazing, but I just wish it had a few more things, though. Belonged on their dev team. I messed this up. What's up, baby? Oh, nice. Yes, no, I really think it's that good. It's definitely that good. It's the kind of game that I wish games were that good when I was a kid. Like it's that good of a video game. Same thing with Axiom Verge. Actually, I might have even enjoyed Axiom Verge a little more than Hyper Light Drifter overall. But if you're really comparing anything though, the art in Hyper Light Drifter is probably the best game art I've ever seen in my life. When it comes to pixel art, especially, but I mean, I'm talking about any kind of game art, but that's probably because I love pixel art so much. But yeah, they nailed the freaking the visuals, the art, the story, the way they convey their story. It's amazing. Yeah. I was saying it's probably one of my favorite games I've ever played in my life so far. Definitely. Okay, I've been doing this too long. Surrender that. Go back to this mirage. Okay, so for him to come in as a mirage. Yeah, slightly more enjoyable than Super Metroid, right? I feel about that too. Super Metroid, though, still is probably one of my favorite games ever as well. Super Metroid, Axiom Verge, Sword and Sorcery, Hyper Light Drifter. Some of the best games. Some of my favorites. Calm down. I know I haven't played Ori and the Blind Forest, and that's definitely on my list. Yeah. I gotta play Ori and the Blind Forest. I also heard Environmental Station Alpha is really good too. Yeah, totally, right? I agree. I think Axiom Verge actually outdid Super Metroid, which is really hard to do. Dust too? You're not talking about Dust Force, are you? But just Dust? Yeah, it did. It definitely did. Definitely did. Oh yeah, cool. Hempoly. Is it this dust? I don't think this is the dust you're talking about. Maybe it's this dust. Is this the dust you're talking about? Oh yeah, this one. Okay. Let me play this. What's up, Alex Pita? Whoa! This reminds me of what's that game for Sega Genesis that was a RPG? Cool. Nice, this looks pretty good. Yeah, doing great. Alex Pita working on the spirit guide today. I'm working on a mirage effect for him now. I want him to kind of like do this crazy cool fade in. I made Dust did the animation for Jazz Jackrabbit? No way! No way, that's awesome! Oh, I gotta. This is kind of interesting too. I was looking at Steam Spy. And I was comparing Hyper Light Drifter, which I'm surprised hasn't got. This is awesome. They're doing really well. They've sold like probably around 120,000 copies of Hyper Light Drifter so far, which means I'm thinking they've made at least a few million. But I'm thinking a lot of these, at least 20,000 of these are their existing backers. But anyways, they're doing great. They're doing great. But check out, looking at the stats for Titan Souls. Titan Souls has sold 180,000 this year. I mean, they came out a lot earlier this year. No, wait, 120? Did I have this wrong? No, wait, yeah. Owners total, 180. Which is crazy because I don't think Titan Souls is that great of a game, personally. It really leaves a lot to be desired. Yeah, they're only 115. And how are my friends doing, Legend of Dungeon? These days. Right? Because Legend of Dungeon also... See, look at this. Legend of Dungeon has done better than Titan Souls and Hyper Light Drifter. 206,000 copies have been sold of their game. So proud of these guys. Robot and Kitty. Anyways, there's a lot to aspire to as a game developer, right? If you sell even 10,000 copies of your video game and you're the one selling it, you don't have a publisher, you're doing pretty well. So, gosh, it's kind of exciting what could happen. Okay, the first thing is just to try a little fade in. And like a shimmer effect. So if he's like 50, maybe copies of him. Thank you, Eminent Anarchy. That's cool. Thanks for saying that. Yeah, what if I go just move this thing around? And start increasing its opacity. Okay, let's get playful here. I want to see what this guy would look like with the mirage effect. So I needed to like do some kind of like actual pixel art to this to like make it look like it's kind of miragey. But I'm going to try just a quick little fade in at first to see how this is going to look in the game, approximately. Mirage South. Okay, so when it creates... When it creates him, I want it to immediately play render.set animation. Wait a minute. Zero needs a way to be invisible as one of his animations, so I'm gonna go make an animation called invisible. Just has the empty.ping, runs forever. Oh wait, empty.ping is gonna be a bad thing. Yeah, we need an actual zero empty. Okay, if I just turn that off. Render out this size of a blank image. Zero. Empty. Oh, wait. Just one single frame. This will keep the sprite. When I create a sprite, it creates it with the texture and everything. And I've no matter what I've tried, even setting everything I can, like I haven't found a way to set... to change a texture at runtime, so I need to like make sure this, or I mean I can change textures but not like everything about a texture, I don't know. Anyways, if I just do it this way, it's easier. This is zero empty. Zero empty. Okay, cool. So now he's going to start with the invisible animation and running it forever. Oh, no, wait. This zero is fine. Yeah, and then once he becomes, he's about to become, when he's on screen and everything, we're on Mirage. Wait, no, this is, we don't need this. We could put this as part of his actual behavior tree. So yeah, when his timer begin, timer 4.6, and also animate Mirage, and then we need a Mirage animation. Okay, let's see if that actually does what we're thinking. So there's a lot to him. This guy, he guides you to the. This is an alternate dungeon. This is where it's not focused on combat as much as puzzling. So he's really sort of a heady but almost hardy character too. I guess it's more heady than hardy. It's all psychedelic. Appears on the edge of the screen and stuff. Walks off. Where are you coming from? Where are you going to? I don't know. Zero empty? That didn't work. Raw sprites here. Zero empty. There it is. Oh, was this supposed to, did I do zero empty? No, that's fine. Okay, well, we'll just touch the. Remove the part of the texture, I'll just rebuild it. And freaking make sure Hammer Spoon's actually on so I don't have to do this again. What the hell? Oh, it's trying to load it via an animation. Which means I need zero empty zero. And put this. Sprites. Oh, I put it in sprites. No wonder. Oh, I don't even need that. That's kind of what I was thinking, actually. That actually kind of worked. Let's see him on the screen if I come in from off here. Let's get rid of that psychedelic effect for a second. Okay, now it's time to make it actually look mirage-like. See if we can do some crazy distortion or something. A wave or a ripple. Crazy. All right, so maybe this should go up a pixel. That's 32. Okay, so he's like a little. It's impossible to line this guy up perfectly. Okay, let me see what this is looking like. This might be kind of what I was thinking, like it's kind of like a ripple almost effect, but really it's supposed to be kind of looking like a mirage. Man, my computer's so like fanned out right now. Because I'm using Open Broadcaster today. Hope the freaking game show fixes itself for me. I emailed support. I got to get a new serial number or something. Interesting, but it's too slow, like way too slow. Man, it's looking weird though with it with him like fading in like this and then walking to the east. So I'm gonna try the east animation first. Okay, so now I got a Mirage E set up. I can. Do that same kind of thing. I'm going to play around with the doing a ripple effect. And I think I'm gonna shoot for like 8 frames long. Starting at like 40%. So 8 frames long. Let's do 10 frames. So this one will be 90%. So there's 80%. This one will be 'Subspace, my name. How's it going, man? Okay, putting that all together, let's see what that looks like. Got 10 frames of blurry, shimmering wateriness. Ah, what did it do there? It's not as mirage-like as I wanted it to be, so I guess I would need to do different blurs at each one of those steps. Let's see what that looks like. Damn, I might have to redo all that. Okay, and this time it's doing a tenth of a second. Well, we'll try a tenth of a second at first. So now I should be able to, oh, did I do the mirage with the right? Hold on. Gotta make sure mirage. Oh yeah, it runs with the system, so that should work fine. The behavior tree runs the animation. Behavior tree already set up to run animations with the right directions, the compass directions and all that, so. I think I figured out how to do that animation right. I could flip it before I do the ripple effect, and that would probably make it look good. But anyways, I want to make it a little bit of a delay before it runs the mirage effect. Because right now, or before he starts walking, because right now he starts walking too soon. There's not enough time to run this mirage effect. Which is 11 frames long, which is 1.1 seconds, which means we would need to start this timer off like 5.4. Is that cool? I can't tell if this is cool yet. He definitely needs to mirage more. He's not miragey enough. And I should probably zoom in on him too so you can tell, like, whoa, what the heck? Especially the first time you see it, you're like, what's that? Oh, you didn't have a shadow the whole time. Oh, that's because, you can't have shadows when you have slightly alpha pixels. I guess that makes sense. He's coming in like a crazy mirage effect anyways. So my plan here is to do 90, 70, 50. Thirty and 10 differently. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, of course. So I'm gonna duplicate this, make it 95. Yo, Vlad, what's up, Blood? Sorry I called you Vlad. How you doing, Blood? What's up, man? How's everything going? How's business? You're great? Nice. Long time, I know. You've been keeping regular hours lately? Do having to keep the regular hours and stuff? I'm wondering how you've been, man. How things been going with the developments and everything? Your eye project. What's up, Sumas? Yo, you got you're home sick now. Yay for sick days. Right on. I'm working on this little guy. This guy, he's like your spirit guide. So he's supposed to appear like all psychedelic miragey and walk off the screen, guide you to his lair. Okay, and I think this should actually start at like 10% too. So instead of 90, I'm gonna do 95. And now we're gonna be 20%. And this, well, let's do this last. First, I want to mirror this. And then since I'm doing 90-ish, I want to do filter ripple 90. And then flip it back. And that should be an opposite kind of flip to that. Yeah, that's the mirage effect I was looking for. Sweet. Make that 20%. So now I'll go doot, 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 doot. It'll be way more like watery mirage-like. You're a finalist to this. Oh, sweet. South by Southwest. 2 week trip. Cool. What's up, babe?
I thought you were on the phone. That's what, nothing. Sorry.
Oh. Yeah, cool. Now I just got to repeat this and do this for all 75. 55. Okay. Flip horizontal. Ripple. This one's a 70 range. Flip back. This one, we go 10, 20, 30. Okay, so this one's a ripple of about 50. No. Yeah, 50. Biggest thing that came out of there is still a secret, so I can't tell you yet. Oh! You're gonna be in Mountain View? Nice! Whoa! That's only like an hour and a half from here. Mountain View's, wow, Mountain View! Cool, man. Your first time in California? Wow. You gotta check out Santa Cruz while you're there. You'll be really close to Santa Cruz. That's a cool spot. If you got time, if you got even any time just to like travel around a little bit. Oh my God, I just realized something about his perspective. That's crazy. I gotta mess with his horns, make this look more perspective-y. Okay, anyways, 55. Flipped it over once. Okay, here we go. 40, 40 is the same, but it's 70. That's good, yeah. 75, 80, 85, 90. No, I'm in Oakland, so I'm in the Bay Area. Like, it's the same area in general, but like, it's a long ways from Oakland to Mountain View. It's a good, I guess if you had perfect traffic, it would only take you like an hour and 15 minutes to drive it, but it's like never perfect traffic in the Bay Area. This one's 85. Back down 10, 15. Yes, definitely, man. Oh, also, if you're going to be in San Francisco at any point, let me know when you're going to be in San Francisco because we could totally meet up for a beer there. That's like a better meeting spot, right? Like, because you're... Mountain View is like just is like south of San Francisco, and then Oakland is like east of San Francisco, and it's easy for me to get to the city, so I can like meet you there basically. So if you're gonna be in San Francisco, let's have a beer, man. I would love to, definitely love to meet up. Was 85, 90, 95. Maybe this one should be 100 actually. Maybe we shouldn't even have this last one. Yeah, screw it, we don't need that. Okay, let's see if that looks better now. Yeah, alright, cool. We'll keep you posted, man. I'll let it know. Best way to get in touch with me, you can always email me. That's a great way. We can plan something over email, or you can also Twitter me, tweet me. Yeah, well, yeah, wait a minute. It's going to be even better with this next update. This next update is going to have this guy, Zero. Let's render this out, and I'll show you what I'm working on here. And man, I wish I could show you the whole game right now, but I really don't have time to jump into like a playthrough or anything, but... I will be doing a playthrough later this week, and yeah, and when you have time, check out the latest update, like after the, like this weekend, basically we'll have the update and everything with this NPC. This NPC is going to be, is a really fundamental shift for the whole game, not the whole game, but like just this one dungeon where, you know, it's the psychedelic dungeon where you encounter this guy, and it's less combat, it's more focused on puzzles. So I'm working on the effect for him, like Mirage. Oh, that kind of worked. It kind of wiggled weird, but it kind of worked. if there's one more thing I want to try adding to this animation, it's some crazy bright purplish energy coming off of him. I'm going to try that. Yeah, it's a lot fuller, that's for sure. And it'll get a lot more fuller until it gets released later. A few months, at least a few months from now. Okay, I want to grab this purple color for the like chi energy and stuff. Like this color here. Okay, so if I take that, frame like that, yeah, if I create a new layer on top of everything else, I can play around with this. Zilton, yes, yes, he already has a name. Sorry, man. His name is Zero. Zilton loves naming everything. You can name his hat, though. You want to name his helmet? His helmet could be an epic helmet from, like, 1,000 years ago. Bullyhorn! Did I say it right? Is it Bullyhorn or Bullyhorn? So maybe this is like 50% there. Maybe it's visible the whole time. Bullyhorn. Bullyhorn. Oh, it's, the R is silent too? Bullyhorn. Bullyhorn. Man, that's hard to say. What's up, Arcane? So that's with a little bit of this pink energy in there. Let's see what that looks like. He's your spirit guide. So this guy starts appearing when you start taking the cactuses, and he teaches you the meditation skill, which is instrumental to beating the game. And you'll see it'll be pretty cool to see how this meditation skill actually affects the game. You'll be like, whoa, sweet. And it basically, he adds a lot more of this non-combative type energy to the game. So the dungeons that he guides you to are puzzle based. They're less about combat. They're more about puzzles. So that's really been on my mind lately. Everything I've been developing the last week, the last 10 days, I'm working on puzzles. I'm working on placing puzzles through the world. Like, how do I place puzzles throughout the regular dungeons? How do I do the patterns for puzzles? How do I make sure the puzzles are all placed, like, you know, so you don't play the same puzzle twice in a world, stuff like that. So, but now that I'm finally got these puzzles in place, I want the spirit guide guy to guide you to the first puzzly dungeon. You gotta be tripping. Yes, you do. Buhlhorn, all right. Okay, this is okay, but it comes to too much of a peak. This is a peak at 80%. Let's peak it more at 50%. And then it immediately drops off back down to like 25. Fifteen, five, 50, 25, 15, 10, 5, that's fine. And see that? That was better because you can see the purple energy helps you be able to really notice him. It draws your eye a lot more than him just shimmering inside. Which gives me an idea. Maybe the whole thing should be shimmery. How's money flow? I have food. Yes, thanks, man. I'm on schedule. I'm doing good. Plenty of people are buying the game now. I can, you know, I'm alpha funded. Everything's good. I got a few months left where I can basically just make this game as good as I can, you know, but I really do I'm on schedule where I do have to get this game out, man. I really do. So I feel a lot of pressure in that regard. I'm quite actually nervous because I want this game to be as awesome as possible. And I feel like I don't have enough time to finish it as awesomely as I could, but I think what I'm actually what I may be experiencing is the same thing every game developer ever experiences, that you get your project, you've been working on it for years, and you get to the end sort of, and you're like, man, I could make it so much better, but it can always be better, right? The person that's developing a game can always imagine something better. There's always one more enemy that can go in. There's always one more, you know, mechanic and stuff like that. You could work on a game forever. So basically my dilemma right now is just to come to that point where I know the game is as good as I can make it. And then I'm thinking that maybe I will actually do like an expansion pack down the road. Like, if I really do want to perfect this game, add in a bajillion Easter eggs, add in more items, add in more NPCs, you know, more tile sets for the overworld so the overworld can be really unique in all the different worlds. Maybe I could just do an expansion pack, and that would at least let me, you know, get this game out as it is now and then work on an even better version down the road, if the game is financially successful, you know? Yeah, you got to cut it somewhere. You got to say, okay, this is good enough, and the game is going to be like this. Yeah, so Zilton, yeah, the cactuses give you invincibility, and they heal you, and they reveal secrets. Sequel ideas? I mean, yeah, I could do, I do want to do sequels for this game, of course, and I will do sequels, but I want, but the thing is, with the sequel, it's different, you know, it's got to be different enough to be a sequel, so I'm really attached and invested in this whole just Songbringer itself, you know, the way it is. I got an idea. I'm going to try some meditative energy around him. This purple color is kind of like the meditation color for the game, or slash the chi color of the game. Think of it like chi, or you can think of it like bioenergy, whatever. This is the color of bioenergy. So looking at this frame, I'm gonna make it nice. Once I deliver my thesis, you can sleep on my couch, no problem. We'll have a party here every night. Ba-bam! So probably not say it. Super cactus. It's a super cactus, but its invincibility timer would reset upon entering each room. What do you mean? I don't understand what you mean by it. Just it resets when you enter the room. So it's on the whole time. Like you eat one and it lasts for the rest of the game, or what? Dang, Pedro. Oh, man. That sucks. I just got mine done like a while ago. I'm so glad to have taxes done. I did them last month. Got them done a little bit early. You don't have to do anything. It's automatic. Oh, blood. What? So jealous. Okay, so on this layer, I want to make like a bunch of copies of this and then make it animate in. Four of these ought to be enough. What's up, Hazard? Zilton, I don't, tell me what you mean about the super cactus again. I don't understand what it does. Well, how it's different than the regular cactus. You said it resets on going into a different room, but what does it do besides just reset? How is it different? Okay, so that is like zero for that animation. Zero, one, two. And three. Mutinous, for the chi energy thing, what about crossing animations to make it look more outer worldly? So the same animations but going different directions, maybe opposite or at other angles of each other? The same animations but going different directions. Yeah, we can play with that, definitely. The timer reset means you can be invincible for a heck of more time. And if you play your cards right, you can finish the game and have the effect on. It's not a finish idea, but I think it's like a... Oh, okay, so I get what you're saying. You're saying about reset, you means it just... You can use it again if you run off the screen while it's still going. I get it. Okay, so I'm gonna try this full animation here, and this was 50%. This one was 25%. Ten, 5, and then reverse it a little bit. 25%, but this time not like that. Like that, 25, 15. Yeah, let's see that. And it would be kind of cool if it shimmered a little bit with the character. But first, I want to see it in the game. This is looking a little better than it was. Hopefully, this looks makes him look noticeable. And at the same time, still like a mirage. Yeah, that was cool. But it would be cool, yeah, to see the mirage effect going with it. But let me check this in so far. I'm liking this. Don't want to lose what I've done. I forgot about this. Some other stuff I already have. Okay. Commit some of this stuff. Git. Commit raw sheets. Raw sprites. Assets. Data friend 0. Okay, there. So I got that checked in already once so I can mess around with this even more and not worry about the changes. So what I was saying there is I want to make this mirage, this bioenergy here actually look more like it is an actual mirage too. So this first frame here, this 0, I'm gonna make this one look like, I'm gonna take away parts where it is miragey. In fact, let's turn this all the way to 0. No, I mean 100. The 100-0, not the 0-0. Okay, put that back to 10%. This frame here. Whoops, it's hard to tell now. Okay, so same thing here with this frame. Man, it's hard to see this animation unless I really make it pretty transparent there. All right, so removing some of the pixels around where it's not doing this effect. You had jabs yesterday? What's jabs? Oh, injections? Damn! I always hate injections myself. Blood, you had to stop your thesis? It's a crying shame, man. Oh yeah, no time. You're over it. Nice, Hilton. That's right. Pain is afterwards. You know, something that really helped me with my fear of like I got a big fear of needles from getting injections as a kid. And then what really helped me was getting acupuncture done. And finally I got acupuncture done for a long time, for like a whole year. I did it like every week. And I had like a working relationship where I would do a website for this one guy, and he would do acupuncture on me, and it really got me over my fear of needles, I'll tell you that. Especially how many needles this guy used. Yep, startup. It almost needs like twice as many frames now, and then I could do the shimmer afterwards and this sort of this thing more at the beginning. In fact, I think I might do that. But let me see it in the game before I make any more judgment calls, because that always changes everything. Yeah, when the time is right. Finish that? Nice. Nice, you're really proud? Show us the logo if you want. Flood, what is it about the animation that seems off to you? Seems off to me too. I'm gonna start with the animation though, making it twice as many frames. Doing the mirage after this sort of pink energy here. So like this bioenergy happens right here. It's like zoom. I'm imagining a really cool sound effect for this. And then as it's fading out, this mirage comes in. Wait. Oh, it doesn't fit the scene? Huh. Well, let me try my little adjustments here and see if that helps it. What's up, voice of Grog? Two-hour notice, all right. Oh, it's not working for me, Zilton. Moving the right angles might help. The corners dropping a pixel. What corners? Which ones? I guess let's just go 10, 20. So that one's 10. With sharp corners, it removes the feeling of flowing, at least to me when it... Oh, dropping the corners. Oh, you mean on the pink or the purple part? The purple part doesn't look like it's flowing as much? That totally makes sense. Yeah. Maybe that's what Vlad's trying to say too, is that these are too sharp of corners here for this mirage-like effect. But maybe separating them out into two different phases will help too. So let's see if that helps. But then, yeah, I can go back and play with these corners and make them more blurry and distorted and stuff. Seventy. Eighty. 95. Oh wait, I got 30. I don't even frame 30. It's supposed to be 35. Okay, let's see that from the start. Oh, there's some problem. It's like, oh, there, this first frame, I don't want that. This frame, I don't want this. What are the, how did these get turned back on? I don't get it. Yeah, this one is where it's like 10, maybe even 5. Actually, this is going to be 5. Oh, crap. Let's make this 5. And this one, 10. And then this one, it's also 10. English is the only language that doesn't have a word for bon appetit. We actually say bon appetit. This might help, having these separated. So let's see. I'm going to export this. This is like almost twice as many frames, so I'm probably going to do it at twice the animation rate too, so... or twice the speed, so this could really change it. Oops, I exported it all as gray! No gray background for you! I know it's not English, right? Yeah, it's not. So, Mirage, let's make this 05. Come on, let's hope it looks better. But you guys have definitely shared some great suggestions so far. Blank link, the link's not working, Zilton. Or at least if I'm on my iPad, it's not working. If we don't have it, we'll steal and call it our own. That's right. Oh, that was way too fast. But it actually was kind of cool. Do half that, so instead of 0.05, 0.75, we'll work on my iPad. Damn. That was cool. I think it needs a little more alpha here, though. That, we got this nice bright energy. That's cool at this point. And then it fades really quickly. So right about this point, we already need to be, like, that's... what are we at here? 10%? Let's go 15 there. Here is 20. Here is 25. 30. So maybe that'll help with a little bit of that. I still thought it kind of needed to run a little slower. Wait, did I export that? Yeah, it's building it again. All right, so yeah, I'm almost done with the stream here. Oh, hey, the image, nice. Days out. Oh, cool. Good job, Zilton. I like it. All right, so I'm thinking it might still need a little bit of like mirage effect, like Mutinous was saying, on that energy. But yeah, I think that's good enough for today. So that's pretty much it for today's stream. I'm gonna just add some. We'll take one more look at that though. Okay. And it probably also, and I'm not sure if it'll need this effect anymore on the whole screen. Yeah, it's still too exact. Like Mutinous was saying, it just needs to bend a little bit, or the colors need to drop on the corners a bit, or something like that, to look more miragey. I could try it really quick here. Filter. Ripple. A second. Okay, maybe that helps. See you in the game. Zynger, what's up, Zynger? Yeah, sorry, it's already been 2 hours here on the stream. I'm closing it down here after I check out this animation. This is Zero. He's an NPC. He's like your spirit guide. And this is his animation for him, like, sort of like Mirage warping in. Yeah, it's better than it was. It's definitely better than it was. I'll keep playing with it. I'll definitely keep playing with this and make it better. But I do need to finish the mechanics. So really the overall mechanics of this are that you you see him. He guides you to a dungeon like this. You go inside his cave, and that's where you get the cactuses for the first time. You use the cactus, and he appears, and he gets you into this crazy dungeon where it's mostly puzzle based. So that's it. His name is Zero for the amount of names I could suggest for him. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully I got my streaming software fixed by next time, so you don't have to watch this crazy stream and my computer doesn't have to like sound like it's blowing up. But anyways, we'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.